Yes, I try to find the magic. That makes my soul sing.
Good morning. Get closer so you can hear me. We're back with our Red Robe review this morning. I'm excited. It's a good day. I've got my shake and, no coffee. Hold on. I'll be right back. Okay, I got it now. And you know what? I'm finishing up my Sumatra blend, so yeah. Okay, this is going to be one of those like health and beauty ones today because I have a lot of new stuff I've been doing. It's getting towards the end of the year. We have like the one more week left. I've been approved for my graduation. I've RSVP'd. I've ordered my announcements. I've ordered my regalia. I reserved my room. I booked my flight. It's all coming together, and I'm very excited. Okay, it is Sunday. I'm getting ready to go to work in about an hour. So I'm trying to get this in. Let's see. Oh, let's start from the beginning. What am I wearing? And I said I was going to know, and I don't. So we will get back to the actual brand name, which Rasolas I don't have handy. So hang on 1 second, and I'll get the name for you so I can just do the whole thing at once. Okay, so what I have on is the Free Tress Equal Synthetic Lace Front Wig, Selena. I had seen a lot of YouTubes on her, and I thought, I like her. She's a lot like the Michelle, the Lady Michelle, only not. The Lady Michelle had the soft lace. This has the hard lace. The Lady Michelle had a design that she was supposed to match, which she really didn't. And she took a lot of work and a lot of curling and a lot of heat. I believe the Free Tress, according to the description, does take heat, but she doesn't really need it. She's designed to be the uneven bob. Let me show you. She, real short in the back, comes down at an angle. And if you do it to the side, as opposed to the middle, which I don't know if you would want to wear it to the middle, but I'm sure you could do her down the middle. Let's do it now. The hairline is edged up, so it's not contoured or anything. So if you like the middle bob, you could do that too. So here's the hairline. I glued it down just at the temples, not the temples, but at the ears, like I always do. So there's only glue right there and right there because I like to make sure she's secure. And I like the adjustable hairline. I like to be able to move it up if I feel the need, you know, depending on the makeup I'm wearing and the colors, or move her all the way back if I think that that's going to give me a better look. I don't particularly have a big forehead because my widow's peak actually comes all the way to there. But if I did the hairlines all the way down to there, I'm not sure how natural that would look. So I kind of pretend that one day I'll get my hair, my widow's peak again, and I move my hairline kind of in the middle of where that was and the new growth that kind of peaks out every now and then it kind of dies away. I kind of get a fuzz and then it fades. So I don't have full-on alopecia. I have psoriasis. So it grows and then it fades and grows and fades and does a bunch of weird stuff. Okay, so that's on the hair. The makeup today is Sephora. I'm trying to think, oh, because I'm between MAC, Sephora, and Walgreens. So I have Sephora, the brown, then I went up to the corduroy. What I did was I put the primer on first, did the white, which I've seen, and then did the brown, the golden brown, and then the lighter brown. Then I edged it with a really dark brown and used the smudge brush to bring it all together. My lips is just a beauty supply store color. As in, I don't even remember the color. It just matches. And so I like it. It's kind of dark, but I do still like it for this morning. I lined it up with a Sephora pencil, and that color would have been Currant. C-U-R-R-A-N-T. The earrings are Target. They're really heavy to be Target. You'd think they'd be more expensive than $7.99 because they're really heavy, but they're really cute. And, and about the hair, back to that, it's soft enough. It's the flyaway hair. I guess you could make it not shiny if you wanted. This is as shiny as it is. I actually slept in this last night. I was really tired. I didn't feel like dealing with the glue again this morning. So I did. I did order, I'm going to be doing a review on the wig grip. I got it. There was a gal on there, Precious. I think her name was Precious something. She's a young gal. She's real sweet. She talks about it. She loves it. So I went ahead and ordered it. I ended up going through Amazon as opposed to Elevated Styles, just for the shipping purposes. So I'll be getting that in a few days, and I'll be telling you how it goes. It's for people who want to glue their hair down, but they glue their hair down every day, and not fool with the glues every day. So this isn't supposed to be a glue. It's a tacky substance that's supposed to hold the hair down. So we're going to see how it goes, because I would prefer the hold of glue, but I would like to take these off at night. And the glues will hold me down for a good solid 3 days at least, even at the temple. And I was taking them on and off with the glue every day. And then I saw one of the tutorials that said that's kind of hard on the lace. And I've started to accumulate quite a few. And I'd like it to, I'd like my investment to last. I think I'm at, at least 25 now. And I'd like my investment to last me. Because I keep them in rotation. It's not like I wear one to death. Well, I do wear some to death. But even the ones I wear to death, I bring them back to life. And I want them to last. So I'd like to know how to wear them every day and not let the glue, because I hear people saying, you know, 2 weeks, throw them in the trash. I can't do that. So that's that on that. So I have to make them last and look good. And even if they get older, look well, good enough to be everyday hair. It doesn't have to be perfect, but at least where it's not like, what the heck rat do you have on your head? I don't want it to look like that. But even if it's frizzy, restyle it to where I have a frizzy style, a frizzy afro style. That's the style I wore when I had hair. My hair was kind of wild and kind of not quite, you know. So that's okay for me, because that's what a lot of people aren't really used to seeing my hair even this neat. This is new. Even to see my hair in a style that is this together is different for me. And most people will know that I have on a piece because it is together. That's too bad, but it's true. It's like today, I think I might even go a little lower with the hairline. I think it'll be okay. What else? Something big I was going to tell you, and I can't even... Oh, I know. First let me finish. There was three combs. There was one here. No, there were two combs here and one in the back. I took these two out, but the one in the back, I guess I just got lazy because there's no reason for me to have it, and I just didn't take it out. So it must just be laziness that it's there. Oh, I forgot my eyelashes. Not fake ones. I just forgot my mascara. I'll get that on before I go. I was trying to do several things at one time. Get breakfast done. Get dressed. I knew I had this to do. And I got to be at work at noon. And so I wanted to kind of have it to where when I finished, I just had a couple things to do. Eyelashes for one. And getting dressed. I do have on my artist garment today, which I'm going to show you the results of that artist garment later. I'm not going to show you the garment. I'm not going to take off my robe and flash it. But I'm going to show you the difference. Now, I went shopping last night with my daughter. Now, I know, I'm going to let you see this. You can see, let me get it back some, that size. Right, it's a 12. I know. I'm getting in a 12. These brown slacks are going on today. Okay? Wow. And a lot of it has to do with the artist garment. A lot of it has to do with my weight loss efforts, which are going to be continuing through 2011. I'm on a 20-pound challenge. I'd like to lose 20 more pounds. Not sure what that's going to do. So even 10 would be good, but I'm going on a 20-pound challenge just to give myself that cushion for not making that mark. If I said 5, you only lose 3, that kind of thing. If I do 20, I can lose the 10. Okay, and that's really where I'm going. But say 20, and I'll make the efforts for 20, and that way hopefully we'll get there. By graduation, I'd like to have a good solid 10 off by March the 11th so that I can shop. in New Orleans and get some cute stuff. Yeah. Lose weight to shop for clothes. Well, I've shipped all my other clothes away to my niece. And so I did that on purpose because I kept thinking, don't keep things that are going to make you go up a size. You know, she's really tall too. She's very much my niece. She's tall, she's stately, and so, but on younger girls, you know, 16, 18 looks good. I've been a 16, 18 for a long time. But as you get older, you want to come down a little bit for health reasons. So I didn't have a problem being her size at her age. And it looks good on her too. But now that I'm older, and then some of my clothes were age appropriate for her. And because she's a businesswoman, and so I had suits and dresses and things that just aren't really fitting my lifestyle anymore. I work from home, and I don't really dress up. And plus, I live in Portland, where nobody dresses up. I know you Oregonians are watching this going, we dress up! Right, you get a new Pendleton and some nice Birkenstocks. But, yeah, that's not dressed up. My dressed up is the city, where everything's tailored and coiffured and... Anyway, we'll get off that subject because I'll miss home again. I need to show you my new shoes. This will give you a good example of Oregon once I show you my new shoes. So hang on a second. Let me show you that because I'm running out of time too. These are my Payless shoes that I got yesterday because I needed a pair. Now, look at all that rubber on there. Now, you need all this. Because it's wet. It's very wet outside. So you need all that. And this is a very nice pant shoe for the area. So it's nothing I would have ever bought before in California. Because you just wouldn't have needed it. I just wouldn't have needed it. So, yeah. So that's kind of dressy. I'm kind of dressy today. Anyway, I'm going to get in that 12 because we're out of time now. So I'm going to show you and then I'm going to let you go. Okay, I'm not sure about this blouse, whether or not I'm going to wear it, but I'm going to back up and show you the 12. Oh, wow. Maybe I need to move the camera. So I got these at TJ Maxx, along with... That's good on toast. Really good on toast. Okay. So here is the 12. Yeah, I'm pretty excited. Pretty excited. Pretty excited. I hope that came out all right. I'll check it out and see. Okay. But for now, I'm going to... Get on off. We're probably at our 10 minute. I know I even get over 15 now. I got an email from YouTube that says, you can do over 15 minutes now. But who wants to listen for over 15 minutes unless it's something really exciting? Or reading. Which, tonight, if I get myself together, I'm going to do a reading. A really surprise reading from a surprise guest. I'm going to contact her today and see if she has her other things ready. If not, I'm going to go ahead and do the reading and post it. Or I might just do the reading and it'll be part of a larger presentation once I get the rest of her stuff. But you'll know tonight. Either way, I'm going to do her reading, which may post or may not post. But I am going to do a reading that will post. And that's going to be from an author, Curtis Alcott. He's recently been picked up by Simon & Schuster, or an imprint of Simon & Schuster. He's got his book out called... I'm so bad this morning. You'll see tonight. I'm going to do Curtis's book tonight. I'll do a little bit out of there and post it and let him know that I've done it. And you guys will enjoy it and all that other good stuff. And I hope you guys like this hair. Let me know what you think. If you know what I mean. Tell me. Here I go messing it up. Let me know if you like it. I don't think I can ever get through without messing my hair up. Let me know if you like it, what you think. If you think it's too staunch. It's kind of supposed to be, though. But let me know if you like it. I ordered a red one in anticipation that I was really going to like it. I did order the F32-33-240, the color of my Mariah. I ordered it kind of a red-like color because I'm going to be having some fun. And I thought red hair would be good for the spring, along with my red leather jacket and some other things. And I think it's going to be cute in a lighter color. But it is winter. Dark colors rule. So you have a great day, and I will talk with you later. Bye-bye.